Good afternoon, everybody. I am Dr. Sonal Dhawan, and on behalf of SRL Dr. Avinash Vadke's lab, I extend a very warm and hearty welcome to you all this afternoon. Today's topic of discussion is allergy. Do you know that 20 to 30% of Indians suffer from some form of allergy or the other? And India being the second most populous countries of the world, she has a population of 130 crores. So in absolute numbers, we are talking, say, 26 to 39 crore Indians suffer from allergies. So which implies that there is an increase in the prevalence of allergy in India. Sometimes I wonder, is allergy a very underestimated chronic disorder of India in the recent times? To know more about it and to give us an insight on this burgeoning ailment, we are very fortunate to have with us a very eminent and renowned allergy specialist, the very famous Dr. Sunita Shukla, who's with us today. And welcome, Dr. Sunita.
Thank you, Sunita.
She is also known as the Queen of Allergy. Welcome, Dr. Sunita, and thank you for taking out time for us for this talk. Now, Dr. Sunita is the founder director of Mumbai Allergy Center. She is an honorary consultant allergist at KM Hospital and Global Hospital. She did her undergrad from KM and MSc&T from Nair Hospital. She took advanced allergy training from Harvard Medical School and Boston Food Allergy Center, New York. She's been honored with many awards. I mean, the list is endless, but to name a few, Dr. Henry Clayman Gold Medal Award, Dr. V. Raju First Prize for Best Research Paper, Best Scientific Researcher of the Year 2017, International Visiting Scholarship USA, Jewel of India Award, National Mahila Ratna Gold Medal Award, and many more. Over to you, Dr. Sunita. I will just ask, I mean, many of our viewers would like to know what is allergy in layman's language? When do we call it an allergy?
Thank you, Sunan. At the outset, I would like to thank SRL Phadke Lab for giving us this opportunity to create awareness among our patients for allergy. So as Sunal asked, allergy is a very common term used worldwide. Anything we react to which is not good, we say we have allergy to it. So allergy means your body is overreacting to a substance, which is usually a very harmless substance for normal people. But if someone has a tendency for allergies, these substances which are called as allergens can cause a lot of problem for that person itself. So that is allergy. Basically, it's overreaction. So in simple term, you're sitting very peacefully at your home on a Sunday watching TV, and one of your relatives comes whom you don't like, and you're like, oh, kyun aa gaya? So that is allergy. Similarly, if some substance enters in our body, whether it is to the nose, lungs, on the skin, eyes, or stomach, and you react to it, and it's not a good reaction, it is called as allergy.
Thank you. I mean, that's such a good explanation. I was just thinking, I mean, is allergy seasonal, Dr. Sunita? Because, you know, there's a saying, I just read it somewhere, that you know it's spring when your nose starts running more than you.
Yes.
So is it a seasonal thing, or there are different kinds of allergies?
Yeah. So we have different type of allergies. So allergies can be perennial, which is throughout the year, or it can be seasonal also. The third type is, it is perennial, that is, it stays throughout the year, but during season it increases, or what we call as the exacerbations. So we have all these types of allergies, and these all depends what are the allergens. So coming to the allergens, for perennial allergies, we have indoor allergens like dust mites, cockroach, pets, but for seasonal allergies, most of the time, these are pollens. Pollens are the small, tiny particles in the center of a flower, which agar aapko yaad ho biology ki koi class mein padhi hogi, so ek phool hota tha, usme anther and pollens hote the. So these are the pollens which are important for pollination of that plant and for the reproduction of the plant. So these pollens during the season with wind, they are in our atmosphere. And the time they enter our nose, lungs, or the eyes, and if you're allergic to it, it can cause problem. So pollen allergies can be perennial because many of the grasses, like the grass which we have in garden in India, it has pollens throughout the year. So if you have that allergy, you will have symptoms throughout the year. But there are some pollens which are seasonal. So these pollens are in the air only during that particular season, like spring or autumn. And then you will have symptoms in that season only. So that time it becomes a seasonal allergy.
So there are two major kinds of allergies.
Yeah.
Kids be affected with allergy? They have allergy?
Yes. So kids can also be affected with allergy. There is a term called as allergic march or atopic march, which I would like to explain to my viewers. So usually if parents have some type of allergies, if one parent have allergy, the chances of kid having allergies is 25%. If both the parents have allergies, the chance of the kid having any type of allergies goes more than 50%. Okay. So once a baby is born and if he has some, allergies in the genetic makeup, like the parents, grandparents and all, chances of him having allergies is high. So usually in the first year, you will see when the kid is born, he may have milk problem. The kid takes milk. It's less than 6 months, 5 months age kid. He will take milk and he will puke it out. He will vomit it out. So it could be milk allergy. Many times kids have very rough skin. You will see eczema on the cheeks,
yes,
elbows, yeah, knees. So this is a type of skin allergy called as atopic dermatitis or eczema. So if the kid has these things in his first year of life, chances of him getting food allergy later and allergic rhinitis, which is allergy of the nose, or allergic asthma, drug allergy becomes very high. So when this kid who has allergy gene, and if the atmosphere is also like that, the time he grows up, he will manifest one or the other form of allergy from childhood into adulthood. So this process is called as allergic march. And these things can affect the quality of life a lot. And why we should know as parents about allergic march is that if you get to know your allergies on time and you diagnose it, we can stop this allergic march. Suppose a kid who is 8 to 10 years of age and he has only allergic rhinitis, jise hum naak ki allergy ya nazla bolte hain, where you are always sneezing, there is itching of the nose, the kid is going on doing like this, there are dark circles under the eyes, these all are features of nose allergy. Chances this kid will have allergic asthma later on is high. So if we diagnose and treat him at this stage, he won't get asthma further. Okay. Hence, we pledge as allergists that these are allergy march and we should try to stop it when the in the infancy or in the childhood stage only, so that it doesn't increase into some other type of allergy when this child grows up.
Yeah, Dr. Sunita, I just realized that you take your breathing so much for granted, and until you have a stuffy nose, you don't realize what,
yes,
you have. So what is the commonest allergy in young people? What kind of allergy,
yeah,
is common?
So Sonal, I am an ENT surgeon also, and I specialize in allergy. So in ENT, we see at least 30-40% of our patients have allergic rhinitis, which I, as mentioned before, the allergy of the nose. Many times we don't realize also it is allergy. We take it so casually or we take it for granted. Like if someone gets up early in the morning and they start sneezing, the person will go to have a shower, he will start sneezing. If there is Indian cooking or tadka happening in the kitchen, they will sneeze. Many times if someone who has put perfume or fragrance, if they go cross next to you, you will start sneezing. So all these are irritants for a person who has nasal allergies. He doesn't have allergy to the perfume. But because of the allergies, the nose is so swollen up that any of these things will act as an irritant. For nose allergies, the most commonest allergen is dust mite. And this is the culprit throughout the world. It's not only India. So most of the allergies are because of dust mite. And these are indoor allergens. By indoor, I mean they are there in your home, in your office. And if you notice in our lockdown period, this 1.5 year, because most of us were indoors, these allergic rhinitis or the indoor allergens, the dust mite, cockroach, all or the fungus, which is very common in this rainy season, these all have increased. So if you have any of these things, you should get it tested to know what exactly am I allergic to.
And how is allergy normally diagnosed? I mean, how do we differentiate whether this is allergy or whether this is a seasonal flu or something like that?
So usually seasonal flu or any sinusitis, what we call, many times people call allergy as sinusitis. Mujhe sinus hai. We all have sinuses. But any infection of the sinus becomes a sinusitis. So when a person has sinusitis, he will have running nose, cold and fever. So fever is a very important part of any infection. So a patient who is allergic, he will not have fever every day. His symptoms will be every day more than 4 or 5 times in a week, and most of the week, agar mahine ke aap dekhenge 20 din usko symptoms ho raha hai. But jise sardi khasi ya jo hum log bolte hai ki infection hai, वो आपका 5 दिन 6 दिन में ठीक हो जाता है. आप एंटीबायोटिक्स लेते ठीक हो जाते हैं, पर एलर्जी ठीक नहीं होती है. आप एलर्जी के लिए वो रात को छोटी छोटी गोलियां लेते हैं जिससे आपकी छींके कम हो जाती है, या आप नाक के स्प्रे लेते हैं. तो एलर्जी आप जब अपने डॉक्टर के पास जाएंगे बहुत ईजिली डिफ्रेंशिएट कर पाएंगे कि ये एलर्जी है या कोई इन्फेक्शन है. फिर जब आपको पता चल गया तो हम इसके डायग्नोसिस में दो सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट है. एक होता है स्किन प्रिक टेस्ट. So this skin prick test is the gold standard diagnostic method for allergies throughout the world. So, and why it is known as gold method is because in this method, we put very small amount of purified extracts of the allergen on the forearm. यहाँ पे हम थोड़े थोड़े छोटे छोटे बूंदे डालते हैं, and we just touch it with a needle. So what happens, these extracts, they go into the skin. And if you are allergic to that thing, it creates a reaction. The reaction is in the form of a bump, like we get when a mosquito bites us or an ant bites us. So it's swelling aa jati hai aur redness aa jata hai, which we call it as a veal and flare reaction. So the time it goes into the body, within 15 minutes you see the reaction. And suppose the patient has lot of skin issues and he can't stop the tablets for these allergy testing, then we go for blood test. But there are many blood tests available in the market. Many are fake also. So you should know what blood test you are doing. So you should meet your doctor and ask for specific blood test. In these blood tests, we do something called a serum specific IgE for that particular antigen. Jo total serum IgE hota hai, wo koi bhi allergen ke liye specific nahi hai. Many times you will see this IgE level go from 30,000, 2,000. I have seen patient with a 17,000 serum IgE level also. That is different. But if you want to know which allergy it is, then in blood test we do a serum specific IgE for that particular allergen. So whether to do a skin prick test or a blood test, meet your doctor, let the doctor understand your detailed history, what allergies you are suffering from, and then you decide about it. But blood tests are very good when the patient has eczema. और देर इज दिस कंडीशन कॉल्ड अ डर्मोग्राफिज्म, वेयर इफ यू सी, अगर आपने चमड़ी पे ऐसे आपने नाखून भी लगाया, पेन लगाया, पूरा लाल हो जाता है, दैट केस वी कांट डू अ स्किन प्रिक टेस्ट. दैट इज द टाइम व्हेन दीज आर द इंसिडेंट्स, या व्हेन ब्लड टेस्ट आर इम्पोर्टेंट. अदरवाइज स्किन प्रिक टेस्ट इज द बेस्ट मोडालिटी टू डायग्नोस, वेयर वी कैन डायग्नोस सम 80 to 100 टाइप्स ऑफ स्टफ एट द सेम टाइम.
एंड व्हाट इज द ट्रीटमेंट फॉर एलर्जी, डॉक्टर सुनीता?
ओके, so in allergies we have 4 pillars of treatment. So one is a right diagnosis. Once you get to know what is the diagnosis, you can take care of yourself, because the second most important pillar is educating the patient or making the patient aware of the allergies. So everyone will have a different type of allergies. Once we know what it is, we tell the patient that these are your things, try to avoid these things and all, and that is called as education, which is a very important part. Third is pharmacotherapy or medicines. So if you see, most of the symptoms of allergies are tackled with antihistaminic tablets, which are very small tablets which you usually take at night, like cetirizine, levocetirizine, fexofenadine, loratadine, all these things. But whenever you take these tablets, you will feel that next day you are not feeling very good, you will have a heavy head, you don't feel like going to work, your concentration decreases. So these are the side effects of these tablets. The other pharmacotherapy is the sprays which we use for rhinitis patient, or if the patient has asthma, we use inhalers of pump. For skin allergies, we again give tablets. You know, so these all are different types of treatment. But here the important thing is these treatment will only decrease your symptoms of allergies. आपको जो तकलीफ है जब तक आप दवाई खाएंगे वो कम रहे कम हो जाएगी, लेकिन इससे एलर्जी जड़ से नहीं निकलती है. तो जब हमारे बहुत पेशेंट होते हैं जो 8-10 डॉक्टर्स के पास जाके आए हैं, होम्योपैथिक ट्रीटमेंट किया, आयुर्वेदिक ट्रीटमेंट किया, गोलियां खा रहे हैं, स्प्रे ले रहे हैं, पर एलर्जीज कम नहीं हो रही. जब आपकी ये स्टेज आती है तब हम उसे एलर्जन इम्यूनोथेरेपी या डिसेंसिटाइजेशन का ट्रीटमेंट ऑप्शन ऑफर करते हैं. इन दिस इट इज द बेस्ट ट्रीटमेंट वर्ल्ड वाइड एंड इट इज द ओनली डिजीज मॉड्यूलेटिंग ट्रीटमेंट फॉर एनी एलर्जीज. हियर द एलर्जेंस आर गिवन इन वेरी स्मॉल क्वांटिटीज ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड वी गो ऑन इंक्रीजिंग द क्वांटिटी ऑफ द एलर्जेंस एंड दैट इज हाउ द पेशेंट बिकम्स डिसेंसिटाइज टू दैट थिंग. सो इसमें जड़ से प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व हो जाती है और पेशेंट टोटली क्योर हो जाता है.
सो डॉक्टर सुनीता, कैन वी से दैट इज एलर्जी क्योरेबल? आई मीन कैन इट बी क्योर?
यस, सो एलर्जीज कैन बी क्योर. यू हैव टू गो टू एलर्जी स्पेशलिस्ट, गेट इट डायग्नोस्ड, एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन द एलर्जीज चांसेस ऑफ क्योर इज वेरी हाई. एंड द अर्लियर यू गो, सो देयर इज अ वेरी सिंपल सेइंग, अ स्टिच इन टाइम सेव्स 9. हम सब ने स्कूल में ये कभी ना कभी प्रोवर्ब पढ़ा था. So this applies to our health also. The earlier you take, consult a doctor for the same, earlier you diagnose it and better is the result of the treatment. With allergen immunotherapy, the results are so good that it not only stops the present allergies, but it will prevent new allergies in the future also. And if it is a young female, if it's a girl child, if she takes immunotherapy, chances of allergies in her children also become less. So these allergen immunotherapy works on an immunity level. That's why it is called as immunotherapy. Basically, it's a desensitization or a tolerance process. But it's a scientifically proven thing, which is going on for more than 120 years now, and it has very good results.
And normally, you know, just from the viewer's point of view, I was thinking that there's a word which is used, that they're using it very commonly, very frequently, anaphylaxis. So right. We would like you to shed some light on that.
Yeah. So anaphylaxis is a severe type of allergic reaction. Severe means the chance that a patient can die. It is so severe. And this can happen within seconds to minutes. So here, if the allergen comes into your contact, what happens? You will get severe itching or rashes in the body. You can have, heart rate will increase. हाथ बहुत छाती में आपको धड़धड़ 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 फीलिंग आएगी. योर बीपी विल गो डाउन एंड यू मे हैव स्वेलिंग ऑफ द फेस, लिप्स, आईज एंड द विंड पाइप. सो द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट थिंग इज इफ देयर इज अ स्वेलिंग ऑफ द विंड पाइप, देयर विल बी होर्सनेस ऑफ वॉइस, की आवाज भारी हो जाना, सांस नहीं ले पाना. इनमें से जब कुछ भी होता है सो द पेशेंट कैन डाई इफ ही इज नॉट गिवन इमीडिएट मेडिकल अटेंशन. This is the time the patient has to go to the casualty of emergency department of the hospital, and immediately all emergency treatment has to be given. So anyone who has allergies should be aware ki anytime they can have anaphylaxis. It doesn't come all of a sudden, but if you ever had swelling of the lips, eyes, face and any of the features which I have told you, it could be a mild form of allergy, anaphylaxis, and anytime it can convert into a severe form of anaphylaxis and which can be fatal also. So that's why you should be aware and you should take precaution and understand what are things you should be doing if such a case happens.
All right. So Dr. Sunita, will antihistaminics, anti-allergics help preventing anaphylaxis?
So anti-allergics will help to just decrease it a bit. These antihistaminics are not the treatment of anaphylaxis. In anaphylaxis, the heart is the primary target organ. That's why it beats very fast, BP goes down, skin reaction happens, breathing problem happens, the lungs are involved. So antihistaminic, if it is a mild, it's good. But if it's a severe allergy, antihistaminics can't help it. The only drug at that time is adrenaline, or it is called as epinephrine. Abroad, we get something called as EpiPen, where an allergy patient will carry it. It's like a pen only, and in case of such reaction happens, they have to inject it themselves in the thigh, in the leg. So in India, that is not available, unfortunately. So any of our patients come to us, we explain them how to, if such a reaction happen, what injections and how can it can be taken, which teach all these things to our patient so that he can safely reach the hospital. Once he is in a hospital setup, the doctors will take care, but he should reach the hospital on time. So for that golden period, we call it. So from home to hospital, we give him some rescue medication so that he reaches hospital safely, and you know, further treatment can be given.
Just about Dr. Sunita, you mentioned about food allergy. So wanted to know, can a person outgrow his food allergy?
Yes. So some of the food allergies can be outgrown, like milk. But there are some food allergies which can't be outgrown, like peanuts. So peanuts, which we call shengdana or moongphali. In India, we are lucky, we don't see peanut allergies. But abroad in the Western or developing world, peanut is the first cause of death because of anaphylaxis. So there, the rules are so strict that kids who have peanut allergy, they can't share their tiffin with anyone else. Like hamare idhar dabba sab log lunch break mein kholte aur sab khate, waise wahan pe strict hai rules, they can't have it. The teachers over there have training in anaphylaxis. If such a kid, someone who has a peanut allergy, if he gets anaphylaxis, how to save him. So many of the airplanes also have this strict rule that you should have EpiPen if someone reacts to anaphylaxis. So bahut sare aircraft mein peanuts are not allowed, especially the ones from the US and Europe. They don't allow peanuts. It's only in our aircraft, Air India, where we get peanuts, you know, shengdana. Otherwise, it is not allowed. So that's the nuisance of food allergy, where peanut is one of the causes in Western world, not India, luckily.
I just wanted to tell our viewers that one of the celebrities, I mean, if somebody's following sports, let me tell you, Serena Williams, the legendary tennis player, who won 39 Grand Slam titles, she is allergic to peanuts. And look where she's reached now. So what Dr. Sunita is saying, I mean, it was good. It's just in the West, they're very, very careful about peanut and allergy and you know what to refrain the patient from. In India, peanut is like, everybody, it's a routine snack.
And you can see it in all the forms. In Maharashtra, we will have it in poha also. We will have it in khichdi also, and we will have chikki also, peanut chikki. Yeah. So we have all form of peanut snacks in our, you know, culture.
So there's a question from one of our viewers. They say, can skin prick test be used for drug allergy, Dr. Sunita?
Yeah, so drug allergy testing is a very difficult thing to do. And what we at Mumbai Allergy Center, we do drug allergy testing the way it is done world over. So skin prick test with one prick, we don't do one drug at a time. And here, after skin prick testing, we do an intradermal testing of the drug also, which is in serial dilutions. And once that is done, we do something called as an oral challenge test. So a patient who has to undergo drug allergy testing, first we do a skin prick test, then we do intradermal testing, and then an oral challenge test. If all these things are clear, then only we say this patient doesn't have drug allergy. Now, just to give you an example, in our center, we have seen rarest of the rare drug allergies. Like we have a sister working in the ICU of a hospital. She was allergic to Avil injection, which she realized when she was admitted for corona. Now, this is, as per literature, sir, this is third of its kind in the world. So that we have detected here.
Wow.
We have seen allergies to cetirizine. One of the patients can't tolerate cetirizine. She takes cetirizine, she gets rashes. So when a patient is allergy to the allergy medicines, you know, it's like rakshak hi aapka bhakshak ban gaya hai. So we can't take it casually, because if this lady takes any drug and usko allergy ho jaya, wo cetirizine le to toh, karele pe neem chadha jaise ho jayega, you know. So it will be fatal for her. So when anyone says these things, we do a proper drug allergy testing. We certify it. And if it is positive, we also tell the alternative. Ki if something happens, which drugs you can take safely. So safety of the patient is of paramount importance. And with drug allergy testing, a patient can have a mild reaction like rashes. He can have a severe anaphylaxis. So one has to be very careful and not ignore these drug allergies.
There's another question which we've got. They say, kind of diet to be followed for my father, who's 62 years old, who has histamine intolerance.
Oh, wow. So it's a very nice question. And I'm happy whosoever has asked it. So histamine intolerance kya hota hai? So what is histamine? Let us understand histamine. So histamine is a chemical which is released in our body when the mast cells are released or whenever there is any allergic reaction. So when the histamine is released, you start getting rashes, running nose, itching nose. So anything which itches, it has to do with histamine. So nose itching, skin itching because of histamine. So many of the time this will cause a bronchospasm also, jo asthma mein dekhte hain. So there are certain foods which release this histamine. Okay, so when they release histamine, so you are not allergic to that food, but because they cause the release of histamine, you get all the symptoms. Just to name few of this food, one is banana, you have cheese, especially processed cheese. The more the cheese is processed, the more it will release histamine. We have certain type of fish, mushroom, and sometimes tomato will also cause it. And all sour thing will release histamine. So, ek hamare culture mein saying hai, kuch bhi itching ho raha hai, to aap khatta khana band kar do. To aapka sab khatta band ho jata hai. Nimbu, orange, achar, jo bhi aapko pasand ho, sab band ho jata hai. So, the basic reason is because these are the things which release histamine. So if a person has histamine intolerance, there are two things. First of all, he should avoid all the foods which have all these histamines or which release it. And alcohol is one of them which will increase the potential of histamine. And the second thing is, if he can't do it, he has to take antihistaminic tablet which will decrease the histamine in the body. So these are the two things which you have to take care of.
Another viewer says, my nephew has fish allergy and vomits every time he takes fish.
There are 8 types of food which cause 95% of the allergy, and fish is one of them. So these food are called as the big 8, and seafood is very important. If you know, last in 2019 February, Sonu Nigam have tweeted that I had fish, and thank God Nanavati hospital was close by and I got saved. Nahi to mere trachea mein swelling ho jati thi. So that was anaphylaxis to fish, or what we call sea fish, whatever type it may be. So this reaction is life threatening, as I said. So if you know that, okay, I'm having fish and something happens to me, so most important thing is, first of all, you avoid it. Then you visit your allergy specialist and you understand what type of fish is it which is causing these allergies. So it could be fish, it could be prawns, it could be lobster, crab. There's so many variety, which we call the crustaceans variety. So if you have that, then what to be done? Because if a child by mistake, suppose he's at home, he won't have anything. He goes to a party, and these allergies are so notorious. To just give you an example, if the child has a fish allergy, he is not having fish. But suppose in a restaurant or in a buffet where you have gone for a marriage or something, if someone uses the spoon which has fish curry also in it, and this child takes his food from that spoon, he can get a reaction. Because it's not that one bite of fish you have to take a reaction. Allergies can be so severe. If you have egg allergy, and if a neighbor is cooking omelette and those fumes reached to the person who is allergic to that egg, he can react to the fumes of egg. So really? these incidences do happen, and the patient then lands up in a hospital. We have seen allergies to yeast, jo bread mein, bakery product mein hota hai. We have seen allergies to black pepper, to turmeric. Many times people say, chalo haldi ka doodh piyo. Aap char baar haldi dal ke doodh pi rahe ho. That person is allergic to haldi, turmeric, and you are giving him haldi ka doodh. Obviously, the allergies will increase. So till the time we don't diagnose, we can't tell you the treatment. But these fish allergies and food allergies are notorious. Because once in a while, if he's vomiting, okay. But what if he gets swelling of the face, swelling of the lips, what we call as angioedema. And what about the windpipe swelling? He can go into stridor, breathlessness. So these things we don't want. Consult your allergy specialist, understand what allergy it is, and there is a treatment also for that. You know?
Another question, Dr. Sunita. I get swelling in my windpipe and I take cetirizine. Does that mean I have anaphylaxis? Am I allergic to everything? And where do I get myself diagnosed?
Okay. So if this is a very practical question, very, you know, the goosebumps come up when you hear such type of patient and we see such type of patients. So this is a type of allergy, and this what you are saying, if you are getting a swelling of the windpipe, please don't take it lightly, because as I said, the narrowest part of the windpipe is where we have vocal cords. If that get, this is the vocal cord, and if wahan pe swelling ho jaye, if get narrowed, you can stop breathing also. So if this is the case, the lip allergy, eye allergy won't, you know, the eye swelling, you won't die because of that. But if you are getting a swelling of the windpipe, how do you get to know all these things? You start the, there is hoarseness of voice. Awaaz bhari hone lag jati. That's the first symptom. And then your breathing will go on decreasing and it will be a choking sensation. And that feeling, trust me, it's very bad when you get that choking sensation that I can't breathe. So if such is a thing, visit an allergy specialist. Get tested to what food or whatever other allergens are causing this problem. And then according whatever comes positive in the report, accordingly it can be treated. But it can be treated. So such a patient should always have EpiPen, or what we give to our patient, an emergency kit with them. In case you are at a restaurant and something happens, you should be able to take the tablets immediately. So at our center, we give emergency kit to all our such patients who give us this history. And you know, we take care that they reach the hospital safely. We have an emergency number also where they can call us immediately and we tell them what not to do and what to do at that time. And we do diagnosis of all these things at Mumbai Allergy Center, which is at Dadar Shivaji Park.
Yeah. Opposite Shiv Sena Bhavan.
Yes.
Is it possible to reduce the frequency of allergic reactions over a period of time by any other method than medication?
Thank you, whosoever asked this question. I am repeating the same thing. The answer to this question is allergen immunotherapy. You can read about it. It's all over the internet. So when you are tired of your taking medicines, because medicine, as I said, will suppress the symptoms only. It won't cure your allergy. But when we give allergen immunotherapy or a desensitization or a tolerance procedure, what it is called, you get your immunity for that thing becomes very strong. I will just give you a very small example, which all of us will understand. We give OPV drops, the polio drops to the kids. So it is only 2 drops, but the 2 drops are so strong that that kid right from birth till 5 years of age, he is getting those drops, but it is into very small, small quantities. So the polio virus is entering the body. It is not causing polio, but it is triggering a reaction where the body will become stronger for the polio virus and the kid won't have polio. Same thing is happening with the COVID vaccination also. When you take the COVID vaccine, they are injecting a coronavirus in the body, but the form is like that the body will fight it and make good antibodies so that you don't get a corona infection. But in case kuch hota hai, toh your body is strong enough to fight that infection. Same thing we do for allergies also. And yes, it is curable. And believe me, when our patients goes through this desensitization, their symptom decreases, their need for medication decreases, their quality of life increases so much. They can have a normal life without depending on the medicines, and the fear of getting anaphylaxis anytime. Some patient, whosoever asked these questions about windpipe swelling, I know that patient, if he has to go out, it's a fear. Maine agar kuch kha liya, kuch ho gaya, to kya? Hamare idhar wo to kya ka answer nahi hai. And to live with that question in your mind is really scary.
Dr. Sunita, since we spoke about COVID, I think that's a very pertinent question which I wanted to ask you for long, and I'm sure many of our viewers would also like to ask. Can a person who's allergic, can he or she take COVID vaccination?
Yeah. So I can't say a blanket yes or no to it. So anyone who has our government of India has come up with a circular that anyone who has severe allergy should not be vaccinated. but there are many ifs and buts to it. So in US, this rule doesn't apply. In UK, where Covishield is used, we are also using the same thing. This rule doesn't apply. It's only here we have this rule. So there are, when such a patient comes to us, we'll do their allergy testing and see what is the level of allergies. Then we even do COVID vaccine test. The components of the COVID vaccines are tested. And if the patient has no problem to it, then we tell them how to take the vaccine also. And we have vaccinated more than 20 to 30 patients by this method at our center, where we test them. And once we know, okay, it is safe to give, then only we ask them to go ahead with the vaccination. And suppose there is some reaction happening, we even tell them how to give that vaccine. Because the benefits of taking COVID vaccine is far, far, far more than not taking the vaccine. The reaction of COVID vaccine is less than 1 or 2 in 1 million. Whereas if you don't take COVID vaccine and you get COVID infection, chances of you, you know, having a lot of ill effects is very high. So we want you to take COVID vaccine. Please take it, consult your doctor, consult the allergist, get it tested and then take it.
There's another question by a viewer. Could you please talk to me about anaphylaxis due to drug allergy?
Yeah. So as I said, many of the allergens can cause anaphylaxis. So drug is one of them. In this case, many times what happened, a patient who is admitted in a hospital or who is on any treatment, they are given 5 or 6 drugs at a time. And you have taken everything together. You don't know what is, and you get some rashes or anaphylaxis. You don't know what is the anaphylaxis due to, you know. So once such patient comes to us, we'll do a thorough drug allergy testing, find the culprit, and then we'll say, bhai, ye panch mein se ye ek hi culprit hai. So you avoid this, but the other 4 you can take very easily. You know, so the testing has to be done and then we can give an answer.
One of the viewers says that my 11-year-old son is asthmatic and I have allergy test in which allergy to yeast, dust and green peas is there. Is there any treatment for it?
Okay. So when you say allergy to the dust, so it is not actually dust. There are some microscopic creatures in it which are called as house dust mites. And these are the one which cause allergy. So these creatures, the microscopic organism, they are in our mattress, in our bed, in our pillows. And the best example is, suppose you go to a hotel or to someone's house and you, you know, they give you a blanket which was kept inside for a long time. And you just take that blanket, you will start sneezing, you will get an asthmatic attack, you can get, you know, wheals on your hand. So the culprit here is dust mite, because they thrive in all this indoor environment of ours. They're there in the carpet, in the sofa fabric. So this madam who has asked that 11-year-old son is asthmatic, chances that he has asthma and the reason is dust mite. So the other stuff which you ask, like Ajinomoto, green peas, they will add to the problem if he is allergic to it. I don't know whether you have done a skin prick test or a blood test, and which type of blood testing is that. There are many types of blood tests. There are many fake tests also there that you give few thousands and will test for 400 things. If you see any of the allergy organizations throughout the world, these tests are not important and they have no value. If your doctor has done a skin prick test and he has come positive to it, then there is a treatment. If your son is only 11-year-old and has asthma, but if it is because of dust mites and pollens and we start the allergen immunotherapy, I am sure he will come out of it and he will have a much better life now. But to give a blanket statement is difficult. Till the time we don't see the patient and thoroughly examine, it's difficult to say.
There's another question, Dr. Sunita. I'm 60-year-old and developed hypersensitivity to perfumes. Is this a kind of allergy and can it be cured?
So, as I said, I don't know what type of testing you have done. If it is a blood test and then they said you have allergies to perfume, we don't accept such blood test. But if you have some nose issues where, you know, if someone is wearing a perfume and someone goes by or someone is using perfume and you start sneezing, then it's an irritant. And your culprit must be something else like dust mite, pollens, pets in your house, fungus, cockroach. All these things can be causing the basic type of allergy. And the nose is so swollen now. Basically, what happens, the nose mucosa is so swollen that if any irritant happens, like a perfume may use start sneezing. So that's not allergy to the perfume. So we have to understand the root cause. So till the time we don't do the testing, we won't get to know what it is. So get it tested, know what's the cause, and then a treatment can be definitely done for it.
All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Sunita. There's another. I sneeze in the air conditioner. Please suggest.
So my answer is the same. Temperature changes is again an irritation because, see, I will tell you a very simple example that also in our mother tongue. Suppose mere haath ekdam normal hai. ये मेरी नॉर्मल चमड़ी, इस पर जोर से मैंने मारा, मुझे कुछ नहीं हुआ. लेकिन अगर मेरे इधर एक घाव है जो बहुत लाल है और सूजा हुआ है, अगर किसी ने उसको ऐसे टच भी किया तो मैं बोलूंगी आउच, यू नो, इतना पेन होगा. सो सेम थिंग इज हैपनिंग विद द नोज. व्हेन यू हैव एनी एलर्जीज, द नोज स्किन और द म्यूकोजा इनसाइड इज ऑलरेडी स्वोलन, वो पूरा सूजा हुआ है, उसमें इन्फ्लेमेशन है. तो थोड़ा सा भी परफ्यूम, धूल, मिट्टी, तड़का, किसी ने झाड़ू लगाया, ये सब आपने थोड़ा सा भी हुआ तो आपको स्नीजिंग होने लग जाएगा, रिएक्शन होने लग जाएगा. सो कल्प्रिट ये सब नहीं है, दे आर इरिटेंट्स. सो व्हेन योर नोज इज सो स्वोलन, देन इफ देयर इज अ सडन टेम्परेचर चेंज ऑफ द एसी, यू विल स्टार्ट गेटिंग रिएक्शंस. सो गेट योरसेल्फ टेस्टेड फॉर द एलर्जीज. व्हाट इज इट विच इज द रूट कॉज, व्हाट इट इज विच इज कॉजिंग दिस प्रॉब्लम. यू नो, करता कोई और है और नाम किसी और का खराब हो जाता है. सो एसी इज नॉट द कल्प्रिट. ओनली इन वन केस इफ यू हैव नॉट क्लीन द एसी. So there are lots of fungus inside. And if the patient has a fungus allergy, then he can have reactions. But not because of the temperature change.
Okay, Dr. Sunita, there's one question. The viewer has asked the difference between food allergy and food intolerance.
Thank you. One of my favorite questions and answer for this. Because I've done a special training at Boston Food Allergy Center. So if someone has anything and anything happens, like मैंने कुछ खाया और मेरा पेट दुख रहा है, vomiting, diarrhea, anything happens, we say the term allergy. So allergy, food allergy and food intolerance are very different terms. In food allergy, it's a reaction of the immune system. So आपके food, आपके पेट में कुछ गया, the body is allergic to it, it will suddenly react within minutes to 1 to 2 hours. And most important thing is it can be fatal. Like I gave you the example of food anaphylaxis of Sonu Nigam, jo fish ko tha, or whatever we have discussed, getting angioedema or swelling of the windpipe. These all are allergies to food and it can be fatal. Isme jaan ja sakti hai. Isiliye allergies diagnose karke treat karna important hai. On the other hand, food intolerance means what? It is a problem of the digestive system. आपने खाना खाया और आपका खाना अच्छे से हजम नहीं हो रहा है. अब वो क्यों हजम नहीं हो रहा है, वेदर यू हैव अ इन्फेक्शन और देयर आर सम एंजाइम डेफिशिएंसी. जैसे कई बार मिल्क खाते हैं हजम नहीं होता, कई बार बहुत गैसेस फॉर्म होती है कुछ भी खाने से, विंड पास होती है. कई बार ऐसा भी होता है पेशेंट ने कुछ भी खाया, उसको इमिडिएटली वॉशरूम जाना होता है टू पास मोशन. सो दीज ऑल, जिसको हम IBS या इरिटेबल बाउल सिंड्रोम बोलते हैं. सो दीज आर अ फॉर्म ऑफ फूड इंटॉलरेंस. लेकिन फूड इंटॉलरेंस से और क्या क्या हो सकता है? हेडेक हो सकता है, माइग्रेन होता है, जोड़ों में दर्द, पैरों में दर्द, ये सब फूड इंटॉलरेंस से होता है. फूड इंटॉलरेंस जानलेवा नहीं होते हैं, दे आर नॉट फेटल. दे उससे आपकी क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ खराब हो जाएगी कि आपको अच्छा फील नहीं हो रहा है, पेट भारी लग रहा है, गैस हो रहा है, नॉट. लेकिन फूड एलर्जीज कैन बी फेटल. दैट्स व्हाई वी नीड टू टेस्ट इट एंड ट्रीट इट अकॉर्डिंगली.
Dr. Sunita, I'm sorry. There's a question. They're saying, I have drug allergy. Some of them, paracetamol and ibuprofen. Should I take the vaccine, the COVID? Yeah. I'm sure he must be referring to COVID vaccine.
Yes, yes. So as I said, when anyone has any allergies, I can't say blanket yes or no. We see the patient. We see what is the level of allergies, type of allergies. And depending on that, we check the nose, we check the lungs, how is the status. And then depending, we suggest whether you can take a vaccine or not. If we feel that this is a very risky patient, then how to take the vaccine under medical supervision, that also we say. So it's very difficult to make one statement for everyone. But yes, it is possible. But we do see the patient, do the testing, check the risk stratification, classify it, and then we go for the COVID vaccination.
Yeah. There is a viewer who has said, can skin problems lead to cancer? I'm sure he must be referring to skin allergies.
Yeah, so skin allergies will not cause cancer per se. Okay, skin allergies means jo commonest hai, what we call as eczema or atopic dermatitis. Usme chamri bahut kharderi ho jati hai, rough ho jati hai, sukhi sukhi phati hui hoti hai. Usse cancer nahi ho sakta hai. लेकिन बहुत बार दो तीन चीजें जब मिक्सअप होती है दैट कैन बी अ कॉज ऑफ कैंसर बट डायरेक्टली अ स्किन एलर्जी वोंट कॉज कैंसर बट यस देर आर सम स्किन कंडीशन जो सनलाइट के एक्सपोजर से होती है टोबैको खाने से होती है या और भी बहुत सारे ये चीजों से होती है उसमें कैंसर का चांस होता है बट स्किन एलर्जी से कैंसर नहीं होता.
Someone has again asked, is allergy completely curable? I mean, madam has already given an answer to that, but
yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Okay. And a viewer has said, I have autoimmune thyroiditis and other autoimmune problems. Are these because of food allergies?
So food allergy is different. Autoimmune means what? It's like, I will give you an example. There are four people in a family and we should be all living in a happy world, you know, one family, four people. But when these four people are fighting among themselves in the house, that is what is autoimmune. So if our body is fighting among its own organs, like some patient has, like you, as you said, you have autoimmune thyroiditis. So this thyroid, which is part of my body should not fight it. But something happens and the body sees this as an invader and it starts fighting with that thyroid. So thyroid mein problem hota hai, it is called autoimmune thyroiditis. We have many types of other diseases also like this, where we have autoimmune rheumatitis also. So this is where the body is reacting to its own body and to the other organs and the cells. So this is different, but food allergies per se won't cause autoimmune thyroiditis. They can add on to your problem and give you a very poor quality of life is both the things are together.
Dr. Sunita, somebody has asked, after bath, there is skin irritation for 30 minutes. Is it allergy?
So there is something called as cholinergic urticaria, where if the temperature of the body increases by even 1 degree, you will get rashes over the body. So ye hamare Indian scenario mein do bar sabse jyada dekha jata hai. One is if someone is having a very hot water bath, so it releases the histamine in the body and the patient gets rashes and itching. And the second time is if many times someone who is exercising, if they exercise and the body temperature increases, they get rashes over the body. So in this thing, the best thing, so this is not an allergy to water or anything. It is just that your body is releasing histamine very fast. Okay. So in this case, we tell the patient that you don't take a hot water bath. Make it a lukewarm thing. And also you should not rub your body after your bath. You should just take a towel and just pat it dry. And very good thing at night to apply for any eczema or this skin patient is coconut oil. We all have used coconut oil right from our childhood. In India, coconut oil is used so often on the skin. Sarson ka tel ho, khopre ka tel ho, sab tel bahut achhe hote hain because they have some antibacterial properties also. We have a lot of research going on in our center, and one of the reasons why Indians don't have food allergies is because they do a lot of massage in their infancy period. Jo bachcho mein massage hoti hai, usse skin ko kitna protection milta hai. Uske wajah se bhi food allergies kam hoti hai. So these research also we do at our center. So as you said, don't take a very hot water bath, make it lukewarm water and try to apply some lubricant, whether it's coconut oil or Vaseline. There are many type of moisturizers and chemical products in the market, right from 100 to thousands of rupees. But whatever a coconut oil will do, sasta, tikau and best treatment in our Indian scenario.
The same question has again popped up. I have allergies and I'm taking medicines. Is it curable completely?
So, yeah. So visit your allergy specialist. What allergies it is, what's the severity? What are the allergens causing this thing? And then depending on that, it can be cured, not cured. Difficult to make a statement. But yes, if it is dust mite, pollens, these are can be cured and it can. I'm not saying 100% cure. It will give you a very good, decent life, which will, most of the time it will be symptom free and you will have a very good quality of life.
That's so important.
Yeah.
I think we are done with all the questions. There's one question which has come up. Are allergic reactions related to any physiological condition?
Yes. So, Hindus में बोला जाता है चिता से चिंता बड़ी. So, कोई भी चिंता आपका स्ट्रेस बढ़ाती है. एंड इस सेइंग में साइंटिफिक रीजन है. जब भी आप चिंता करते हैं, whenever you are stressed, you know the hormone changes. जब आप हंसते हैं, that's the concept of laughter therapy. Even if you are stressed, if you laugh, जैसे आपने मुन्ना भाई MBBS में वो डॉक्टर को देखा था जो हमेशा हंसते रहते हैं, टेंशन में तो जोर जोर से हंस रहे. तो जब आप हंसते हैं, इट इज माइंड ओवर बॉडी. यू आर ट्राइंग टू फूल योर बॉडी दैट आई एम इन अ हैप्पी स्टेट, एंड दैट्स व्हाई गुड हार्मोन्स आर रिलीज्ड व्हिच विल डिक्रीज मोस्ट ऑफ योर प्रॉब्लम. इफ यू आर स्ट्रेस्ड, स्टीरॉइड्स लाइक कॉर्टिसोल आर इंक्रीज्ड, देन दे विल एक्टिवेट हिस्टामिन वेरी फास्ट एंड इट विल इंक्रीज ऑल टाइप ऑफ एलर्जीज. तो कोई भी स्ट्रेस है, डिप्रेशन है, कोई भी फिजिकल स्ट्रेस जिसे हम बोलते हैं, जैसे आपने सर्जरी कराई है, कोई भी और प्रॉब्लम है, तो ये सबसे बॉडी का स्ट्रेस हॉर्मोन्स बढ़ते हैं, इसलिए आपकी प्रॉब्लम भी बढ़ती है. तो ऑलवेज ट्राई टू बी हैप्पी. इफ योर माइंड सेज आई एम हैप्पी, द बॉडी विल फॉलो इट एंड यू विल सी कि आपकी बीमारियां डेफिनेटली कुछ हद तक कम हो सकती
है. वेरी ट्रू, वेरी
ट्रू. सो इट्स ऑलवेज माइंड ओवर बॉडी.
वेरी ट्रू डॉक्टर सुनीता. आई थिंक वी हैव कम टू एन एंड एंड वी हैव हैड such an enriching session with Dr. Sunita. As Dr. Sunita rightly said, allergies are no respecter of people. They affect all aspects of life, be it the rich or the famous. To name a few, I mean, there's Serena Williams, which I said, she's won 39 Grand Slam titles, and she has peanut allergy. And the legendary footballer, David Beckham, had asthma when he was a child. And to top it all, I mean, I found it very intriguing when I got to know that Tiger Woods, the greatest golfer of all times, he was allergic to pollen. Can you believe it? And he's on the golf course. I mean, his work was he was a golfer and he had to be on the golf course, and he was affected by pollen. And he took shots when he was young. What Dr. Sunita just said, there's a treatment available. And now he's and we all know, I mean, where he's reached. So thank you very much, Dr. Sunita, for enlightening us. And it was a wonderful, wonderful session. And it's a pleasure to have you. And thank you very much to our viewers also for taking us time. Dr. Sunita, would you like to say something?
Yeah. So thank you, Sonal, for giving this beautiful example of celebrities. So I would like to, you know, end with this one thing, that with asthma, you know, asthma are of various types. If it is allergic asthma, so if you have allergic rhinitis, chances of having allergic asthma is very high. It has a treatment. Get it diagnosed, whether it is dust mite, pollens, as she gave example of Tiger Woods, it can be treated. In US, we have these allergy shots where you are given injections and your allergy get cured. So these things we are also doing in India now, and any of the asthma should not take us back. If you Google search celebrities, you know, players who have asthma, you will see all of them are performing so well. And let me tell you, whenever a patient has asthma, it comes with the intelligence gene. So if you see, and I'm not joking, I can quote a scientific paper for this, most of the asthmatics are very intelligent. You can research American president who had asthma and you will see what all results you will get. So I won't name any of them. But yes, if you have asthma, it can be cured. Your asthma should not limit your life. If properly treated, if you are taking treatment properly, you can run a marathon, you can do a triathlon, you can swim, and you can do what not. You know, I thank Sonal, SRL, Padke Lab for giving us this opportunity to connect with our patients. And I'm very happy to create a social awareness about allergy. So that's the purpose of our center, which is Mumbai Allergy Center. And my tagline is, please give wings to your life. Wow. And it's a beautiful butterfly. We want you to come out from the cocoon of allergies. I have seen my patients suffering so much socially also because of allergies. They don't go out with their friends. They don't go out for dinner. People embarrass them. People reject them. And it was so disturbing that we came up with this allergy center, which is a one-stop solution for all type of allergies. Whatever treatment is done at one of the best international centers, we do it at our place. even the treatment. So we have this center at Dadar Shivaji Park. I have a YouTube channel which is for social awareness of my patient called as Mumbai Allergy Center. I have put videos like allergic rhinitis, dust mite allergy, allergen immunotherapy. I have some testimonials of my patients who are so happy with the treatment. You know, you can see this, and if you have any doubt, if you want any of the videos or any educational stuff about any allergic condition, please message us, leave us a comment on Facebook or YouTube channel, and I will be happy to make that video which will benefit so many of them. You know, so I thank all the viewers to connect with us in this afternoon, weekday afternoon mein aapne hum log ka saath kiya. I want to thank all the people who asked all the questions, because एक पर्सन जब क्वेश्चन पूछता है तो वो 10 लोगों के डाउट्स क्लियर करते हैं. सो थैंक यू फॉर आस्किंग द क्वेश्चंस एंड थैंक यू वंस अगेन. थैंक यू एसआरएल फटके लैब.
थैंक यू. बाय. इट्स अ प्लेजर हैविंग यू विद अस. थैंक यू. एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू.